In this lecture of analog communication, we will understand the second method, a phase discrimination method for the generation of the SSB SC modulated signal. Single sideband suppressed carrier signal or SSB SC signal is consist of either of the two sidebands, namely upper sideband or lower sideband signal. Based on these two sidebands, SSB SC modulated signal can be classified as upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal and lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal. Graphically, this upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal can be shown as, and the equation of the upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal is, if we take this AM into AC divided by 2 common and apply the formula of cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, then the equation becomes, again, the lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal can be shown as, and the equation for the lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal is, in this lecture, we will understand how to use phase discrimination method in order to generate SSB SC modulated signal. It was stated that basically there are three types of modulators that can be used for the generation of the SSB SC signal, and they were frequency discrimination method or filter method, phase discrimination method or phase shift method, and Weber's method or third method. Now, in this lecture of analog communication, we will understand how the phase discrimination method or phase shift method is utilized to generate SSB SC modulated signal. So, let's get started. Let's see the block diagram and understand the working principle of the phase discrimination method. The block diagram is consist of two product modulators, two 90 degree phase shifter and one local oscillator and one summer block. Two product modulators are supplied with the input message signal which are 90 degree out of phase from each other, namely the incoming message signal MT which is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT and a 90 degree phase shifted version of the message signal MT or Hilbert transform of the message signal MT which is equal to AM sin 2 pi FMT. The voltage control oscillator is used to generate the carrier signal. The two carrier signals generated by the voltage control oscillator or VCO are in phase quadrature or 90 degree out of phase with respect to each other as the one signal is passed through a 90 degree phase shifter. The frequency of the voltage control oscillator is adjusted to the same as the carrier frequency. The upper path of this block diagram is known as in phase path and the lower path is referred to as quadrature path. The two signals generated from the two product modulators, namely V1T and V2T, will be given as input to the summer block, and the summer block produces an output which is either sum of the two input signal or the difference between the two input signal based on the polarity of the inputs. So this SSB SC modulator is consist of two parallel paths. One is called in phase path and the other is called quadrature path. Each path involves a product modulator. And the sinusoidal carrier waves generated by the VCO is applied to the two product modulators are in phase quadrature, which is simply taken by using a phase shifter. However, the one functional block in this block diagram that requires special attention is the wideband phase shifter, which is designed to produce Hilbert transform message signal in response to an incoming message signal. Depending on whether upper sideband or lower sideband is required, the quadrature path acting as the wideband's phase shifter's only function is to interfere with the in-phase path and also to remove the power from one of the two sidebands. The two modulators are of clearly quite different in their structure. In terms of design challenge, the bandpass filter in the frequency discriminator stands out as the functional block that requires special attention. On the other hand, in the phase discriminator, it is the wideband phase shifter that requires special attention. Let's see the mathematical analysis for this phase discrimination method. At first, you will see the operation of the upper product modulator, which is placed in the in-phase path or in the upper path. For the upper product modulator, modulating signal or message signal MT is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT and the carrier signal from the local oscillator or CT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. Now, the output of the upper product modulator is the product of these two signals. Hence, the output of the upper product modulator or V1T can be written as V1T is equal to MT into CT. If we put this value of MT and CT as AM cos 2 pi FMT and AC cos 2 pi FMT, then V1T can be written as V1T is equal to AM into cos 2 pi FMT into AC into cos 2 pi FCT. Now, we can rearrange this equation as AM into AC into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now we will divide and multiply this equation of V1T by 2, then the equation will become V1T is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now, if we apply the formula of 2 cos A cos B, which is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B, in the following equation, then the equation of V1t can be written as V1t is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. This equation can be simplified as AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. So this V1t is the output of the upper product modulator, and this will be given as the input to the summer block. Next, we will see the operation of the lower product modulator, which is placed in the quadrature path or in the lower path. For the lower product modulator, modulating signal or message signal is 90 degree phase shifted, and it is equal to M prime T, which is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT minus 90 degree, which can be written as AM into sine 2 pi FMT. This AM sine 2 pi FMT is the Hilbert transform of the message signal MT. Carrier signal taken from the local oscillator or AC cos 2 pi FCT is also passed through a 90 degree phase shifter, or the carrier signal becomes C prime T is equal to AC into cos 2 pi FCT minus 90 degree, which becomes AC into sine 2 pi FCT. Now, the output of the product modulator is the product of these two input signal M prime T and C prime T. Hence, the output of the lower product modulator or V2T is equal to M prime T into C prime T. If we put this value of M prime T as AM sine 2 pi FMT and C prime T as AC sine 2 pi FCT, then the equation becomes V2T is equal to AM into sine 2 pi FMT into AC into sine 2 pi FCT. We can rearrange this equation as AM into AC sine 2 pi FMT into sine 2 pi FCT. Now we will divide and multiply this equation of V2T by 2, then the equation will become AM into AC divided by 2 into 2 into sine 2 pi FMT into sine 2 pi FCT. Now, if we apply the formula of 2 sin A sin B in the following equation, then the equation of V2T will become V2T is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T minus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. This equation can be simplified as AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T minus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now, this V2T is the output of the lower product modulator, and it will also be given as the input to the summer block. So, finally, the outputs of the upper and lower product modulator, which are V1T and V2T, are given as the input to the summer block to perform either addition or subtraction of the output signals from two product modulators. Addition of these two output signals from the product modulators will result in lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal, and subtraction of one signal from the other will result in upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal. Now, in order to generate lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal, we need to add V1T and V2T, where V1T is the output generated by the upper product modulator and V2T is the output generated by the lower product modulator. So, the output of the summer block or V0T is equal to V1T plus V2T. We can put the value of V1T from the previous equation as AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, and V2T as AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T minus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now, after performing this addition and subtraction of the terms, this equation of V0T can be simplified as V0T is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T, which can be further simplified as V0T is equal to AM into AC cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. And this is the equation of the lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal. In order to acquire upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal, we need to subtract V1T from V2T. Then the output of the summer block can be written as V0T is equal to V1T minus V2T, and again we can put the value of V1T and V2T from the previous equation. Simplification of these two equation will result in AM into AC divided by 2 into 2 into cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T, which can be further simplified as V0T is equal to AM into AC into cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now, this is the equation of the upper sideband SSB SC modulated signal. So, by using phase discrimination technique, we are able to generate both upper sideband and lower sideband SSB SC modulated signal. Now, let us see some drawbacks of this modulation. One of the main considerations of this modulation is that the phase shift must be exactly 90 degree, but it is almost impossible to get exactly 90 degree phase shift. Generally, the phase shift angle is less than 90 degrees due to the losses and resistance in the circuit, and when this happens, we cannot properly generate the output signal from the lower product modulator. And also, when we generate multi-tone message signal, it is very difficult to obtain a phase shift angle of 90 degrees. Hence, it is not possible to maintain this 90 degree phase shift. That's why this method is not applicable for multiple tone message signal.
That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button, and see you in the next one.